The beginning of this parasha, Kisova, the Torah says, V'hoya kisova l'ha'oretz asher Hashem elekecha doise l'cha nachalo, when you will come to the land of Israel, which God will give you as an inheritance. V'yushavtubo, you'll be established over there. And then, v'lokachto mereshis kol pri ha'adama, you will take of the first of the fruit of the land. And the Torah goes on to tell us, you have to give it as an offering, bring it to Jerusalem, and give it to the Kohen. It's one of the obligations that the community has to support the Kohanim, to bring to offerings to Jerusalem in the Beit HaMikdash. But it was something very particular in the Mitzvah of Bikurim, how it was offered, in a very unique way that we don't find with any other of the offerings that we had to give, the tithe, the levy, etc. And in the 6 minutes that I have in today's little thought, I'd like to share with you some of the highlights of the actual way how it was brought. Basically, it starts when a farmer in Israel and of some surrounding areas would find budding fruit of the seven species of the land of Israel, which are wheat, barley, grapes, figs, pomegranate, olives, and dates. He would then tie a reed around them of the first budding fruit and declaring them, this is first fruit. Then at least, according to the rabbinic halacha, at least 1/60th of the crop, the first fruits, were brought to the temple. And this was any time from Shavuot, which the Torah calls the harvest festival, and until Hanukkah. They were packed in special containers. Wealthy people would use trays of gold and silver, and the less wealthy would just use baskets of grass and reeds. An ox with horns coated in gold would lead the procession. A crown of olive branches on its head, representing the seven species from which the first fruits were taken. A flute was played before the procession until they approached Yerushalayim. When they came close to the gates of Jerusalem, emissaries were sent to the inhabitants to notify them, we're arriving with Bikurim. The leaders of the community, the Kohanim, the temple treasurers, they would all go out to greet them. They proceeded through the streets of Jerusalem, accompanied by music from a flute, until they actually reached the Temple Mount itself. There, even important people, the King of Israel himself, placed baskets on their shoulders and proceeded until the temple courtyard, and always singing the last psalm of the Tehillim, which is a psalm of tremendous praise for all that God has given us. Then, there, while the basket still on the shoulder of the farmer will then make the first declaration. I declare this day to Hashem, your God, that I have come to the land which the Lord swore to our forefathers to give us. He then held on to the edges of the basket, and the priest held it from below and waved up and down in the four directions before reciting the special formula where they will recount the history of our forefathers, how we were nearly destroyed, Egyptian exile, and then finally God's kindness of bringing us to the land of Israel. Then he would place the first fruit near the southwest corner of the Mizbeach of the altar, and he would bow, and then he would leave from that place. The first fruit were given to the priests who were on duty at that time. They divided the produce among themselves to be eaten within the walls of the holy city of Jerusalem. They could not take it out of Jerusalem. It was considered a holy food to be eaten only in the holiness environment of Jerusalem. Then the priest took the fruit and returned the expensive containers to the owners, those who brought it in silver and gold. But in case of reed or grass basket, both the first fruits and the basket were given to the priest. After sleeping in Jerusalem overnight, the farmer was free to go home and then enjoy his produce. That's the practical application. Now, there are many details and messages we shall take from this. And if God forbid, tomorrow we're not yet in the Beis HaMikdash, I will discuss it further.